If you've ever tried to add video to your Next.js site, you've probably run into a few common problems. The first is that video files are big. You don't want to store them in your Git repository. They take up lots of bandwidth and they load slowly, if they're even compatible with your browser. The second is that video players are tricky. If you're hosting your video on a service like YouTube or Vimeo, you're stuck with their player. If you're hosting your video on your own, then you have to use the browser default or spend lots of time developing an accessible player that fits your brand. And don't even get me started on timeline previews, captions, analytics. Well, Next Video can help with all that, and so much more. Here's what we're building today: a page with a responsive player and an optimized video. And here's the code, just a few lines. To begin, I'm going to create a Next app. Of course, you can add this to your existing Next application too. To install Next Video, let's run the init wizard. This command will walk you through setting up your project for use with Next Video. This does four things for us. First, installs Next Video as a dependency. Second, updates your Next config file. Third, adds types to your video file imports if you're using TypeScript. And fourth, creates a video directory in your project, which is where you're going to put all your video source files. Now, we said earlier that you shouldn't track large files in Git, and you also don't want to burn up loads of your provider's bandwidth with large video files. So where does Next Video store its files? By default, Next Video uses Mux for video storage, optimization, and delivery. Mux is built by the creators of Video.js, powers popular streaming apps like Patreon, and has seen its video performance monitoring in the largest live events in the world. To start, you'll have to sign up for a Mux account. No credit card required. Once you have a Mux account, you'll want to create an access token. And finally, add that access token to your environment variables. All right, now we're ready to add video to our app. There are two parts to adding video to your application. The first, uploading the video. The second, adding the component to your code. To upload your video, add the video to your videos folder and run the sync command. This will tell Next Video to check your video folder for anything new and to upload that. If you don't want to run that command every time you add a video, you can also tell Next Video to watch your videos folder by adding this to your dev script in your package.json. New versions of Next Video add this to your dev command automatically. Now that your video is uploaded, let's add it to your app. If you've used Next Image before, Next Video should feel familiar. First, we see we have a player right out of the box. Without any configuration, we have controls, a poster preview, even timeline hover previews, and a video being served in optimized renditions from Mux's fast infrastructure. And if we go back to the Mux dashboard, we can even see that the player is sending us analytics. If you've ever done any part of this yourself, you know how nice it is to have this done for you. I'm going to go a step further and apply some style to this. A maxed width, a small change to make the player match my branding. Yeah, that's better. We support more advanced use cases too, like loading a video from a remote source like S3. Check out our docs for more information. So that's Next Video, the easiest way to add high performance video to your Next.js application. And that's just the start. Coming soon in version 1, you'll be able to customize the player even more, connect to additional video services, not just Mux, easily add AI-generated captions, and you'll have access to a template with everything you need to build with Next Video. Check it out and drop us your thoughts. We'd love to hear what you think.